morning, Harrelson County Rebels. I'm Crystal Lockhart with your morning news. Students, are you behind on credits? Would you like to go to school for half the day and work the other half while earning credits towards graduation? Is transportation a barrier that is keeping you from working? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then the Southwire 12 for Life program might be for you. The program is now taking applications. See Mr. Saxon in the College and Career Academy for more information. Mr. Saxon also has some internships available to any high school students who might be interested in completing one before graduating high school. The Tanner Health System's Connections Internship Program offers placement areas in healthcare, information technology, marketing, graphic arts, registration, business office, and education. Again, if you're interested, Mr. Saxon is the man to see. And now, here's Ms. Rutherford with some important info about Project Purpose.
Good morning, seniors. I wanted to tell you guys about a really exciting opportunity that we have called Project Purpose. Project Purpose takes place after you graduate, a week after you graduate, so you can still go on your senior trip. Then you come back to us if you're interested in going straight to the workforce, or if you're gonna go to the technical college and you have classes half the day, but you would also like to work to earn money. So one of the cool things about Project Purpose is it's a week-long speed dating with business and industry that's local to Harrelson County. There'll be cool businesses there like Firemaster that make things for firefighters, Tide and Brooks that makes all the security seals like are on airplanes and tractor trailers, and a lot of other industries. So this gives you an opportunity to meet and greet with these 10 business and industry, and at the end of the week, you decide who you want to interview with. These businesses have to have entry-level positions open, and they all have to pay competitive wages, which means you'll be making more than $10, $12 an hour. So that sounds really great, especially coming right out of high school. They have to interview if you request it, and those interviews will take place on June 11th and 12th. And so you could come out of this with a job paying $17 an hour and ready to go to work. For your part, of course you get to hear different offers from different companies and choose the best offer for you. You also get a couple of other things that week. You get a lesson in personal finance, how to set up your checking account, how to do your taxes. Those things that, you know, people on Facebook say you don't learn in high school. They're gonna help you with your resume and help you get prepared for your interview so that you are able to be successful at the interviews on June 11th and 12th. They'll also go over some basic safety things with you guys so that you're ready to enter the workforce and ready to hit the ground running. They're gonna feed you lunch and breakfast each day, so don't worry about that. And this will take place at our Chamber of Commerce. So if you're interested, if you will, of course, scan this QR code that we have for you here, and you can also look in your Google Classroom. If you're interested and have questions, please stop by and see me or Ms. Schulenberg, and we're happy to answer your questions.
Thank you, Ms. Rutherford. In sports news, the slow pitch softball team received two more big wins against LaGrange on Tuesday evening. Game one's score was 7-6, and game two's score was 14-3. We hit a total of 6 home runs. Way to go, Lady Rebels. The next game will be Tuesday, March 21st, away with Osborne. And in tennis action, Harrelson County's doubles teams also had a good week last week. On Tuesday, Karis Wade, Lexi Smith, Michaela Berry, and Heidi Albury all had wins against Gordon Central. And on Thursday, Kat Kimball and Annalene Coy won a marathon match against Model. Congratulations to our girls' soccer team, who won their last game Tuesday against Rockmart. The final score was 2-1, with both goals scored by Lena Grace Fisher. This was their first region win. Attention current and former French students. As you know, Madame Cole is organizing a trip to France for June of 2025. If you have or will have completed French 4 by the end of the year, you are eligible to join the trip. If you need more information, stop by Madame Cole's classroom, room 124, or use this QR code to get details about the trip. If you book by April 15th, there is a $200 discount. Now let's have a look at this week's weather. And now here's Cole Reagan with the director of the upcoming production from the Harrelson County Theater Program.
Good morning. Today we're here with Haley Kilgore from the Harrison County Theater Program. Tell us what's going on, Haley.
Hi, I'm the student director for our theater this year, and I'm a senior here at Harrison County High School. I am directing our upcoming show called The Seven Torments of Amy and Craig. Pretty much, it's a couple that breaks up over and over and over again, and they can't stay away from each other, but they also can't, like, they want to be together. And throughout the show, it's a comedy, and I really think everyone knows an Amy or a Craig in their life, a couple that just can't stay away, but they want to be together. But that is pretty much the show so far.
Can you tell us about the show?
So our show, pretty much, it is the student-directed show in which we get one of our seniors or our juniors, whoever does it that year, they get to put on a show and they get to direct it as they were Mr. Steak. And we put it together, we work together, and we get it done. It's, like I said, it's a comedy, and I think a lot of you would like it.
And how would someone get tickets to that?
So tickets are on GoFan. You can also buy them at the door. They are $5, and that's pretty much it.
What about the process of directing the show? How has that been?
So the show has gone very good so far. I think it's coming together very well. I do enjoy being the director, and I do enjoy doing this because I love having fun doing this, and I especially love just being there and putting it together and going on about it.
Anything else you would like to share with us?
Also, it is Theater in Our Schools Month, and I would like for all of you to celebrate Theaters in Our Schools Month, since March is the month of Theater in Our Schools Month, also Music in Our Schools Month. And I especially would like you all to come watch Anastasia, which is our spring musical that we are currently working on now, and that is in May. But yeah, that's pretty much it.
Okay, thanks, Haley. Back to the studio.
As many of you are already aware, it's prom season, and we have several important items coming up. For seniors, the last day to nominate prom king and queen is Friday, March 22nd, so please go to your grade level Google Classroom to do so, or here is a QR code to submit your nomination right now. Prom tickets will be sold in Ms. Barkley's room in the main building before school from 8 to 8:30 and after school from 4 till 4:30. They'll be available March 19th through March 29th. Cash and checks only will be accepted. Checks should be made out to HCHS, and tickets are $50 each. Class dues must be paid before you can purchase a ticket. Seniors, be aware that your prom invitation is not your prom ticket. If you are classified as a senior in Infinite Campus and you have paid all of your dues, you receive one free ticket for yourself. If you are bringing a date that is not another HCHS senior or does not attend HCHS, you must purchase his or her ticket. Students purchasing a ticket for someone who does not attend HCHS must know the person's name and date of birth when purchasing the ticket, as well as fill out an HCHS prom guest form. This form is available on the school's website, outside Ms. Barkley's room, the main office, counselor's office, or attendance office. Guest forms are due to Ms. Barkley by March 29th. Also, if you are changing the person you are attending prom with after purchasing your ticket, you must let Ms. Barkley know by Wednesday, April 10th. The person the school has listed on your date is the only person who will be allowed to enter prom with you. Also for seniors, if you want to be featured in this year's senior video, it is your job to submit photos and video for possible inclusion. You can get the files to your class officers on a flash drive, or you can submit files to the assignment that is posted on your senior Google Classroom. The deadline to be included in the video is March 29th. That's the last day before spring break. Talent show is set for March 29th during fourth block, and tickets will be on sale this week. The cost is $5, and please be aware that there are a limited number of tickets. First come, first served. You can purchase tickets from Miss Wade in room 424. And if you have a talent you'd like to showcase, signups for the show are open until this Friday, the 22nd. Attention, current Beta Club students. Please remember that all service points are due March 29th, 2024, before spring break. Also, mark your calendars for the new members' induction ceremony on Friday, May 10th, 2024 at 10:30 in the Fine Arts Building. Attendance is required. The Fellowship of Christian Athletes meets every Friday morning in the gym from 7:50 to 8:20. This week's speaker will be Aubrey Buddy. And that's it for the morning news. Have a great day, and remember, it's a great day to be a Harrelson County Rebel.